and welcome to Pet Style Health and Wellness. Now, today we're at the Center for Specialized Veterinary Care right here in Long Island, and today's topic is nutrition. We all love to give special treats to our cats and dogs, but before you slip that treat under the table, you should realize you may be harming your pet. Not only could you be harming their nutrition, you could rack up hundreds of dollars in veterinary bills. Nobody wants to see that. So we're going to go inside. We're going to talk to Dr. Diane Levitan, and she's going to give us the lowdown, the scoop on the do's and don'ts for feeding your cats and dogs their special treats. Dr. Levitan, so good to see you as always. Over the past decade, we've become a nation obsessed with nutrition, the low-carb diet, the Atkins diet. How much should we impose that type of dieting onto our pets?
In some instances, we find that the low-carbohydrate diets are a lot healthier, but you really need a good balance.
Now, when I go to the pet store and not the vet, I will see pet foods in there that say veterinarian recommended.
You know, there are ways to tell if foods are acceptable. But when you see veterinarian recommended, it doesn't mean very much. It only takes one veterinarian to recommend it.
When you're label shopping, how important is it to read the labels, and what should you be looking specifically for?
If you try to look at the label here, the ingredients can be so confusing because the ingredients are there by weight. So yes, they're listed in order of how much there is, but it's by weight. So they may say that chicken is the number one ingredient, right? But if the next three ingredients are three different grain products, if you add up the weight of the three different grains, you may actually have a lot more grains than you do chicken.
Oh.
And so it can be very misleading. There is a standard that's been created by an Association of American Feed Control Officials, and that's the AAFCO. And if you look on a dog food can or cat food can, you should see the AAFCO statement.
What would you say makes good nutrition in the foods for your cat or dog?
It has to have the right balance of protein, carbohydrates, and fat.
Okay.
And for cats, it's extremely important that they have meat. Cats are carnivores, and they really do need to have meat in their diet. Cats cannot formulate one very important amino acid called taurine. And so they need to get that, and they can only get that through meat. I would never recommend somebody formulate their own diet at home that's purely meat, because that's going to lead to other problems too, nutritional imbalances, and most likely malnutrition.
And then what about for dogs?
For dogs, very similar. Dogs, though, if you think about it, they also were carnivores, but they can also digest carbohydrates, which is unusual. You don't really think of them eating plants.
My mom's dog likes to eat spaghetti.
You see? Well, they like it. That doesn't necessarily mean it's good for them.
What happens to an animal? What are the consequences of poor nutrition?
They're going to have problems in their skin and their hair coat. They're going to have immune problems. They're going to be thin.
We all love to sneak our pets little table scraps. So I'm notorious for giving my cats milk. And I know some people are very notorious for giving their cats meat and everything else from the table. How bad is that?
It's really not so good. Well, sausage and hot dogs, salami and ham, they're very high in fat. And so that is just one of the worst things that you can give your dog or your cat, really. High fats in excess are going to give dogs and cats pancreatitis very often. Pancreatitis is extremely painful, potentially deadly inflammation of the pancreas. We don't know very well what causes it in general, but we do know that after they've eaten a high fatty meal, like the fat from your steak or gotten into these things on the table, they're much more likely to develop pancreatitis. It's a classic story. So I always tell people when they want to give their pets treats, please just avoid the fatty foods and these meats, and they're just so rich.
Big no-no.
Chocolate. Bad, 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 bad. Chocolate is poisonous for dogs. It's poisonous because of the caffeine in it and also because of a chemical called theobromine. Onions and garlic, believe it or not, are also poisonous. They cause blood disorders in dogs and cats in high quantities.
Okay.
So we want to avoid that. Little specks of it, you don't need to freak out.
Right.
But onions in high quantities will cause a problem with their blood.
Now, I was surprised to see on this plate the cheese.
Cheese is a dairy product. Dogs don't have lactose. You know, if you get lactate milk and lactate cheese, then you can give it to them because they don't have the enzymes to digest milk and cheese as they get older. Only
cats?
When they're puppies. Same with cats. That's why we don't recommend it. A couple things really that are not on this plate are raisins and grapes. And those are things that I think a lot of people don't realize are poisonous. So small quantities of raisins and grapes are also very dangerous for dogs and probably for cats.
Corn on the cob.
Well, everyone likes to, you know, laugh when they watch their dog chew on the corn, except nobody's laughing when they end up in the emergency room. Because what happens is they chew it, they have a great time with it, they swallow the cob. They bite into it, and if they get a piece of corn cob in their stomach, for some reason it likes to pass through the stomach, but it doesn't like to go through the intestines. It likes to get stuck. And that's surgical. And so that becomes a very expensive, very painful, very unpleasant piece of corn. Avoid corn cobs.
What about canned corn?
So corn itself is not bad for them.
Oh, okay.
So if you look at ingredients in dog and cat foods, oftentimes you will see corn. So I think the point here is just corn off the cob.
Okay. What about the, I see over here we have popcorn.
Some people want to give their pets treats. So not the raw popcorn, only the popped popcorn. But if they have popped popcorn, it's okay to share it with your pet. And here are some other good things that you can actually share with them. You know, everybody wants to give them a treat. We don't have ice cubes on here, but ice cubes are fun.
Right.
But vegetables and fruits are really good, and a lot of pets will really enjoy them.
Yeah, my brother-in-law's dog loves carrots. Like, if you just say carrots, she's like, whoa, freaks out. Just the word carrot.
He needs to teach her to go to the refrigerator and grab them.
No. Thank you, Dr. Levitan, for the crash course in nutrition. All these fresh vegetables. Hopefully someone will enjoy them tonight.
Absolutely. I'm going to make a salad.
Yes.
Get it for yourself. Absolutely.
And again, thanks for joining us. Remember how important pet nutrition is. If you have any doubts whatsoever about your cat or your dog's nutrition, certainly consult your veterinarian. It's important stuff. Gotta follow it.